Hello, Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. I did this video and somehow the sound did not come. I use a Logitech 9000 Pro webcam, and many a times I get a note when I'm making video that there is no sound, and I can't imagine. I have consulted Logitech, they could not solve the problem. So I'm very much upset, you know, that I make a video and there's no sound, making it useless. However, let me know if you don't get it, I can have to do it again, or suggest me a webcam which is more reliable. Here I'm going to do Luke 10 verse 38-42. Martha was once born, whilst Mary was twice born, of clean heart, capable of receiving gospel treasures that were showered by Christ Jesus. Remember that Martha invited Jesus to the house, and she was preparing meal and other thing while Mary sat beside Jesus listening to gospel. Now Mary used to work as a prostitute to make money for the family. They were poor, and today even some married women, they do the same job, you know, for the upkeep of the family. So she was doing for the sake of money because they were poor. And Jesus met her and told her, "So far you are faithful to Abraham. Yahweh will provide you everything. If you are unfaithful to Abraham, then Yahweh won't provide you." So she understood it because she was a devout person, spiritual one, and also the temple priest, the other people, you know, they were having a very hateful eye at her because she was doing the job of prostitution. They were looking her low, not realizing that why she was doing it or anything. So in their eyes, she was a great sinner. But Jesus, in Jesus' eye, she was a clean-hearted person, very good, receptive of gospel. She was seeking gospel. She never cheated anyone. So Jesus told her, "This is not an honorable profession what you are doing. You meet people who are crook, and you are maltreated." So she stopped doing that one, and then she was, whatever she used to have it, she was contented with the lot. And Lazarus was sitting at the door of a rich man, looking for scraps to come from his house to eat. So Jesus entered a village where a woman whose name was Martha welcomed him. She had a sister named Mary Magdalene who sat beside the Lord's at his feet. Now, Lord, this is a Messianic Jew, they have corrupted these things. There is no Lord in the royal kingdom of God. Lords, they have slaves. We are not slaves, we are set free. We are laborers, solitary workers. At his feet, listening to him speak. So she was the customer for the gospel. Martha, once born, she could not understand gospel. So she was thinking, you know, that she is just wasting time because she couldn't understand. Remember of the 12, Peter was once born. Peter could not understand gospel. For him, you know, different. When Jesus said, when somebody hit you on one cheek, present the other, he said, no. No way. That is why he was carrying sword in it with him, you know, as the custom demanded over there. But Jesus did not tell him that you should not carry sword, because under free will, you can't say anything to other person. You do what you like it. You are solitary and you are master of your own destiny. You have to give your own account to God. Nobody can give your account to God. So there's no need to interfere in somebody's business. Martha, once born, burdened with much serving, came to him and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me by myself to do the serving? That means she was, you know, worried, you know, that hey, she's doing all. Look, she's sitting there and listening to the gospel. She couldn't understand gospel, Martha. So for her, she was wasting time. Tell her to help me. Our anointed elder brother, and not the Messianic Jews Lord, said to her in reply, Martha, Martha, you are anxious and worried about many worldly things. There's need of one, only one thing, which is spiritual treasures that count in the court of our Father. Mary has chosen the better part, and it will not be taken from her. Remember that gospel is cannot be written down in ink on paper. Excuse me. Gospel, you have to understand it. You have to have ears to understand it. And after you have understood it, then you preach gospel from your own heart. You can't preach if what is written. It can't be written down in ink on paper. It is written over the living tablets of your heart when you understand it. And that is called drinking the blood of Christ. Remember Jesus, when he feed 5,000, he said, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus, or what came out of the mouth of Jesus with your ear, the ear in the mouth, and drink the blood of Christ, which is when you have digested it in your heart, and then you bring it from your own heart, explaining what Jesus has said. In his honor, you preach gospel to glorify our Father. That is called drinking the blood of Christ. So these treasures, you know, which are gospel treasures, like money, you put it under the pillow or put it in the bank, it gets reduced in value by the time. More you spend, less it is. Spiritual treasures, more you spend, greater they are. And they are not stolen, they are because they rest where your heart is. They are in the heart. Nobody can steal it. They can kill you, but they can't steal gospel from you. So the gospel is the one which more you spend, more is given, and it is as safe as your own physical body. So this was the gospel, and hope you will understand it. And I'm sorry for that, the voice, the sound was almost very low or almost dead, you know. So this is the defect which my webcam has, and I don't know whether I should buy Microsoft webcam, and that will not affect it, because it says the software supplied by the Microsoft to Logica, it is affecting that one, you know. And for 2-3 days I could not make video on this logic, on this Pro 9000 Logica webcam, Logitech webcam. Our Father God blesses you.